This is Lee. His Amway business has been doing really well. Wow, he is very close to achieving new platinum, a significant milestone and fundamental leadership level in the Amway business. Lee's achievement in the Amway business wasn't an overnight success. With his upline's guidance, he focuses on selling, sponsoring, and serving his downline and customers. Lee's upline, Bob, is also close to achieving his next pin level and even more rewards. Lately, Bob has been subtly suggesting that Lee and Lee's group aren't selling or sponsoring enough for the team to achieve its next goal. Lee continues to work harder to increase his sales volume and recruits new applicants. 1 month later, Lee realizes that his sales volume was somewhat short of what is required in order to remain on track for the next pin level. Lee has a great idea. He decides to order a few additional products to make up for the shortfall. He thought, I can easily sell them off next month. Bob has been pressing Lee to increase the numbers of new IBOs joining the group too. To try to satisfy Bob, Lee decides to add two of his relatives into his downline group. Unfortunately, as Lee expected, the two relatives remained uninterested in joining the business. Nevertheless, since they're his family, Lee decided it wouldn't hurt anything to go ahead and register them. So he discreetly took care of it himself. The next month, Lee is again short of sales volumes required to achieve the 21% level. Poor Lee again decides to buy extra products for which he has no orders, just to hit 21%. Oh no, the same thing happens again the next month. Lee has certainly begun to stockpile quite a lot of unsold inventory in his house. What do you think is Lee's mistake here? Lee has misrepresented his sales record by purchasing products not needed to satisfy ongoing customer demand, but strictly in an attempt to achieve a higher level, which he should not have done. Because Lee experienced pressure to help the team, he tried to take a shortcut and made purchases he should not have. For the same reason, Lee added names of people to the group without their consent, which is also against the rules. The excess inventory purchases and phantom IBO registrations are not a truthful reflection of the sales and sponsoring activity in the group. Instead, they represent a serious manipulation of the Amway business. Moreover, these unethical choices have not only undermined Lee's integrity, but are likely to have far-reaching effects on the organization as well. Misrepresentation of sales, including purchasing products that have no sales associated with them, is prohibited. The product volume being ordered from Amway each month should closely reflect the actual sales activity of the group in that same period. As a result, IBOs do not accumulate excess inventory, which might create a temptation to try to sell through unauthorized channels at discounts or in bulk, seriously damaging the ethical business culture Amway works so hard to promote and maintain. No pressure, either stated or implied, is ever to be put on downline IBOs to make unsustainable business decisions, regardless of whether the benefit goes to the downline IBO, the upline, or the team. Integrity is at the very heart of any IBO building a successful Amway business. The future of our business depends on IBOs faithfully demonstrating the Amway value of integrity, on which Amway was founded and has been built. And it's this commitment to integrity that is key to helping each IBO realize their true potential in Amway.